Zai has in oh she has been Zai has in Utrecht voor 9 weken gewonnen.
Almost. You are very close, but she has already been living. So ze woont al 9 weken in Utrecht. So it is present, is it present perfect?
Simpel.
Present simple, ja. Yeah. So it's now. Dus ze heeft niet gewoond, maar ze woont er nu. Dus Thomas, als je me de vertaling kan laten zien.
Oh ja.
Ze woont al 9 weken in Utrecht. Has already been living is al. Al 9 weken.
But yours was also pretty close, but that is the present perfect, which we will
Ja.
go over next week. So you're already ahead of the curve.
Ja, oké. Great. Let's move on to the sentence four. The Dutch lessons are on Wednesday evening. Let's see. Sarah Kalman, can you translate this sentence?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, sure. Sorry. It just with my friend we're listening to the same. All right, so the Nederlandse lesson zijn op woensdagavond.
Ja, goed. De Nederlandse lessen zijn woensdagavond. Great. Good job. Let's move on to sentence six. Shall we go to the pub on Friday? Simona, Simona, hopefully can you translate this sentence?
Zullen we vrijdagavond naar een kroeg gaan?
Ja. Zullen we vrijdagavond naar de bar of naar de kroeg gaan? Great. And then we'll go to sentence eight. Jacqueline Lirio Brandes. Can you translate this sentence?
Yes, hi.
Hi.
Actually, this is my first lesson with you
Oh,
guys.
hi.
I'm
Nice
sorry,
to meet you.
I
Great.
was not here last week. I couldn't join. Yeah.
Oh, no worries.
Do you know this or can you?
A bit, I just don't remember less. It's like lateste
Ja, laatste jaar, afgelopen jaar.
jaar. Okay. Ben jij naar Italië?
Ja, almost,
On some, I don't know the past that much, I'm sorry.
No problem, no problem. So, afgelopen jaar of vorig jaar, so net last year, vorig jaar ben ik, so I is ik, to Italy, naar Italië geweest op zomervakantie, on summer holidays. Ik. And you can also like it's, this is really a difficult one because of the sentence replacements. So last year's at the beginning of the sentence, but we put it somewhere in between the sentence. But it's ik ging vorig jaar voor zomervakantie naar Italië. So we were really close. Great job. Good job. And Thomas, will the answers of the uneven sentences be online as well?
We can put them online
Yeah, maybe.
maybe if you care.
Yeah.
So please write in the chat if you care. If you don't, then I won't know. But if you do, then I will provide those answers. We will provide those answers.
Yeah.
But we won't go over them here. I can quickly go over them here, and you can just see if what you wrote down kind of vibes with what that was. So for the first one, good morning, how are you doing? Is goedemorgen, hoe gaat het? The third one is I have two brothers and a little sister. Do you have any siblings? And that would be ik heb twee broers en een zusje. of een klein zusje of een kleine zus. Kleine zusje. Heb jij broers of zussen? And then for the fifth one, what time do you go to class? Hoe laat ga je naar de les? Of ga je naar les? Ga je naar... Yeah, synonyms for class. And then, it rained all day yesterday. Gisteren heeft het de hele dag geregend. Of het regende de hele dag gisteren. So if you had something that resembled that, good job. A lot of these are kind of difficult because we didn't treat word order yet. Which will be lesson 4. Okay, then we have the other ones. Bonus, I will also quickly go through. I don't have them on slides, but only the fifth one I will ask someone. So first is, ik heet John en ik kom uit Wisconsin. So, dus wat is de vraag? What is the question? The question is probably, wat is je naam en waar kom je vandaan? What is your name and where do you come from? Interrogation style. And then the answer is Smith. So the question would probably be, wat is je achternaam? What is your last name? And then probably the next question will be, what's your mother's maiden name? And the street you grew up in. Then the actual answer is, ik studeer economie. So the question is probably, wat studeer je? What do you study? Then he says, hiervoor studeerde ik scheikunde. So the question will probably be, wat studeer je hiervoor? Of wat heb je nog meer gestudeerd? And then the answer is, omdat ik heel erg van stroopwafels hou. So, can someone tell me what a question would be? There are a lot of answers that could be possible. So maybe, nah, I'll just I'll wait for a tribute. Let's see. Does anyone have a good question for this? Ah, Marina.
Yeah. Waarom studeer jij in Nederland?
Yeah, nice. That's also what I thought. Very good. Waarom studeer je in Nederland? Why do you study in the Netherlands? Because I really like stroopwafels. Great. There's a lot of other answers possible, but that's the one that popped into my head. So good job. You think like me, so you do good. Okay. Then we have het werkwoord van de week, which is spreken. Spreken, which means to speak. Wow. We are doing politics, and people in politics like to speak. Because otherwise they can't get information across. If they just texted it, it would take a long time. So the present simple, tegenwoordig tijd, is ik spreek, jij je spreekt, hij zij het spreekt, en wij jullie zij spreken. The past simple, de verleden tijd, is ik sprak, jij sprak, hij zij het sprak, en wij jullie zij spraken. And then finally, the voltooid tegenwoordig tijd. The present perfect, which we will cover next lesson, is ik heb gesproken, jij hebt gesproken, hij zei het heeft gesproken, en dan wij jullie zij hebben gesproken. Maybe, I'm not sure, Evelien, can you do a better R than I do? Like a proper rolling R? Because I cannot. I can say good sprak. Spreek.
Nee, ik zeg, ik spreek, sprak. Heb gesproken.
Ik denk you dat do it from the back of your throat.
Ja, yeah, it's yeah. The same as you do it. So, sprak.
Sprak.
The rolling air, ja. Yeah. Sprak, yep. Spreek.
We're unfortunately not the fanciest Dutchmen, the Dutch people. We won't get a newscaster job. Nah, we will. Okay, that was werkwoord van de week. Very exciting. Okay, then, way more exciting. The first, like, I don't know, 15 minutes of this lesson will be dedicated to giving you a short introduction to the Dutch political system and, probably 20 minutes, Dutch political system and the political landscape in the Netherlands, because next week we have elections, and it's good to know what are these people up to, you know? What are they doing? What are they talking about? Who cares? So, that's what we're going to do. Feel free to interrupt us with questions at any time, as always.
Yes. So let's start with an overview of the Dutch political system. As you may know, we have a king, Koning Willem-Alexander van Oranje-Nassau. And well, that's because we have a constitutional monarchy, een constitutionele monarchie. And the position of the king is stated in the constitution. So his function is stated in the constitution. So we also have, next to the king, we also have a prime minister. Well, what are the duties, or what is, well, what tasks has the king? The king is, well, a really formal position. He mainly has to represent the kingdom of the Netherlands, for example, on trips to the trips abroad. The king is a representative, but the king is also the person who signs a law as the last person. He has to accept the law before it can be carried out. Lastly, and he is also part of the administration, the regering, together with the ministers, met the ministers. And the ministers are sworn in by the king after the formation. Dus de koning die beëdigt de ministers. They are sworn in by the king. And the king is also has a weekly discussion or meeting with the prime minister to talk about the developments. Really important is that the king is inviolable, onschendbaar. So that means that the prime minister is responsible for all the actions and the statements by the king. And the prime minister has to give an explanation to the parliament when they are asking about something the king did. For example, his trip to Greece last autumn, it was a bit controversial, and the prime minister has to had to explain why the king went to Greece. So it's not the king, but the prime minister who has to explain all the actions and statements of the king. Well, that's the constitutional monarchy. Next, Thomas?
His trip was controversial because it was during Corona, not because we hate Greece.
Oh, yeah. So the political system, we have like a decentralized state, that's called. It's not all from the top, but we have different levels who can decide things. And it's called the House of Thorbecke, because Thorbecke made the Dutch constitution in 1848. So we have three levels. The lowest level is the gemeenten, the municipalities. And the gemeenten make decisions about construction and where they make a plan for constructions, and they also give documents for construction, but also documents like your passport and your driver's license. But they are also about security on a local level, so the police and the firemen, and maintenance, for example, garbage and those things. So it's really local, on a local level. Then next we have the provinces, so provincies, and we have 12 of them in the Netherlands. For example, the province Utrecht, and the Utrecht city is the capital of the province Utrecht. But you also have a capital, Amsterdam, and Amsterdam is the capital of the province Noord-Holland, North Netherlands. So we have 12 of them, and they focus on spatial planning, ruimtelijke ordening. So can we build more houses, or where to make more industrial areas? So in the province, that's their decision, and they are deciding about the infrastructure, the infrastructuur, dus de wegen. That's up to the provinces. Then next we have the highest level, that's the state, and the state, well, their main duty is to make laws and to make policies. And we know the most about the national level. That's most of the time that's in the news. Well, all these three levels have someone who is like the head. For example, the national level is the prime minister. Then on level of the provinces, so we have the commissionary of the king. And in the municipality, we have the mayor. That's like the highest level. Then we have they're also the chairman of the, they're also part of the chairman of the mayor is chairman of the gemeenteraad, so the local council. And the local council can be elected every 4 years. Then we also have the college van burgemeester en wethouders, and that is the board of councillors and mayor. And they are like the ministers, they have a certain subject, for example, education or safety or and on local level, and they make policies about that. On the level of the province, we have the same, the provincial council, that's elected every 4 years, it can be elected every 4 years, and then we have provincial executive, so the gedeputeerde staten, and they're also about policies and certain subjects they are about. So they are not elected. Only the provincial council is elected every 4 years. And on a national level, we have the Tweede Kamer. So those elections for the parliament are next week. We can choose them. Then with the cabinet, and the cabinet is a group of ministers and secretaries, and they also make policies. These three levels are on in the municipality, provinces, and in the state level, you all have these three levels. And then you have the lowest levels are elected, so the parliament, provincial council, and the city councils. That's, I think, the most important overview of the political system in the Netherlands. If there are any questions, you can ask them now.
I want to add one thing. We have the second chamber, the Tweede Kamer, the parliament. And we also have a Eerste Kamer, first chamber, the Senate. They all check the laws that the second chamber proposes. And they are elected at the same time as the Provinciale Staten. So you vote for the provincial government, basically, every 4 years. But those votes also get collected and count towards who gets to be in the Senate. That's really weird. I don't know why we do it like that. The only reason I think of is that, you don't want to vote four times. That's annoying. So we do it like this. It is a bit weird because in the provincial elections, also a lot of parties join that are only about that province and don't have a national party like the VVD does.
Yeah, it's because I think the Senate, we don't directly choose the Senate. The provincial council chooses who is going to be in the Senate. So when we choose a provincial council, you indirectly choose the Senate.
Which is an interesting system. I mean, it's better than, I guess, how the Brits do it with their House of Lords, because that's just really, really weird.
Yeah.
Just be born into the Senate. Weird. But whatever. Yeah, so that's a very broad strokes political system. I don't see any questions. So what we will do next is a little exercise where you have to do something fun. So here we have a political compass. It's not like the political compass you usually see online, because this is the real world and not the online. And so we have two axes, links and rechts. So left and right, economically kind of. And then we have progressive and conservative. So progressive and conservative, kind of social issues. So this is a social axis and a economic axis. Those often overlap. As you can see, these are the parties, and it is sort of kind of a straight line, but not really. You have some outliers like this guy and this guy. And then the question is, who are they? And that is the exercise you will find out. So we're going to put you in groups of three. We will assign you a political
Party.
Yeah.
And
we will tell you which one, and you will know which one because it's on the name of the group. And you will have to do some research about that political party. And namely, you will have to find out whether they are progressive, more conservative, or more left-wing or more right-wing. And that is in Dutch terms. And then together, we have this little sort of game. We can pick out, try to guess which ones are which. We will pick the six biggest parties, just to be kind of fair, and those are also kind of evenly kind of mixed. So that's nice. To just give you a little bit of context, the main issues usually where people think about in terms of left-wing and right-wing in the Netherlands are rechtse partijen usually want to lower taxes for corporations, dus lagere belasting voor bedrijven. En linkse partijen willen dat niet. Leftist parties don't want that. Linksere partijen willen hoger minimumloon, higher minimum wage. And right-wing parties don't want that per se. Don't want to make it lower, but don't want to make it higher at least. What else is a good thing?
Bijvoorbeeld zorg. You can say the right is much more for private, so not in privatisering, so not in the hands of the state, so much more up to the market. Let the market do everything. And left is pretty much to intervene as the government has to intervene and has to help the healthcare and the education. Mm-hmm. So right is meer op de markt gericht, so markt mechanism.
Yes. Maybe you could also tell progressive and conservative while I do the rooms.
Yeah. Conservative is very traditional. So you don't really want any changes. You're happy with the way it is. For example, conservative parties they want to keep Zwarte Piet, a tradition in the Netherlands mostly, or they are for not of much intervention with the European Union. They want to keep it like traditional way. And progressive are very much more go forwards for the future. They want to rights for the gay rights. They want them, and they want make abortion possible. And they're very much more progressive and forwards, and less traditional. And those are the two axes, left and right, and conservative and progressive. And you are going to find out where your party will be in this.
Yes, indeed. So, and we have six parties, and you will be assigned a room, and I think you'll figure out which party you are. We have group one, the VVD. You will find out about the VVD. I won't give the name of the party because I can't give it away, but you can figure it out. You'll find the name of your group, I think. Otherwise, we will give you a link to their website in your group chat. Then we have the PVV for group two. Then we have CDA for group three. For group four, we have D66. And then for group five, we have GroenLinks. And for group six, we have the SP. And your job is to find out, like in broad strokes, are they kind of left-wing, right-wing, progressive, conservative? And how much in that direction, sort of. And then together, every group will kind of guess which dots corresponds to their political party. Okay? Clear? Okay, cool. See nods. Then I will start the rooms, and we'll send you the information that you can look up. You could also, I guess, Google the name of the party and then left wing or right wing or a political compass. Maybe don't do that. That's kind of boring. So, okay. Good job. And try to do it sort of in Dutch, but you have to read. The goal is to read, not per se to discuss. You can discuss amongst yourself in English if that is not possible in Dutch, which I can assume. Okay, good luck. I always say good luck, and then I start the rooms, and it takes like 10 seconds for you to go in there. You'll make it. Oh, and you have like 5 minutes. Or don't spend too long on it. I will send this information again. Cool, dat ging goed. Ik denk niet dat ze echt de room kunnen zien.
Kunnen ze bovenaan niet zien de naam van hun room?
Ik denk het, maar ik weet niet zeker.
Volgens mij wel, want toen ik vorige keer in een breakout room zat, zag ik ook welke kleur ik was.
Oké.
Okay. Dus ik, als het goed is, zien ze dat wel. En anders dan horen denk ik wel in de chat. Mm-hmm. En gaan we dan zo meteen gewoon via die tool of gewoon even heel snel gewoon...
Ja, let's just do the tool. Ik heb hem gewoon wel...
Oké,
ik heb naar iedereen even die ding gestuurd en ik stuur zo even de website van de partij. Ik bedoel, het is niet zo heel moeilijk, het is pvd.nl, of ik wil pvda.nl.
Ja, ja. Ja, het gaat er natuurlijk om dat ze even de hoofdpagina lezen en dat ze niet inderdaad gewoon gaan zoeken van VVD rechts of links. Ja, dat is te makkelijk.
Ja. Hey, ik heb het gevoel dat de SP op zich best wel makkelijk is. GroenLinks ook wel.
Ja.
Wel in de naam.
Ja, dat denk ik. Ik denk dat ze misschien met CDA, want CDA is best wel midden natuurlijk. Dat ze niet
ja, het is meer natuurlijk ook de oefening. Welk bolletje is het?
Ja, precies, ja.
GroenLinks is ook een van de weinige partijen die niet een afkorting heeft.
Nee, klopt. Je zegt geen GL. GroenLinks, nee, dat klinkt raar.
Ja, ik is de andere, enige andere partij die het niet doet, dus denkt het dat?
En 50 plus, je ook nog.
Oh, ja.
Ja, grappig. Ja.
Oké.
Ik ben benieuwd of het lukt.
Ja, ik ook. PVV.nl. Volgens mij is de hoofdpagina van PVV. Oh, shit. Ik stuur het in het verkeerde chat.
Oh.
Oeps. Volgens mij is de voorpagina van de PVV staat ook gewoon weg met islam of zo. Dus.
Oh, oké.
Okay. Ik denk dat een beetje te gokken welke ei als
het ja, is. Precies, ja.
Oké. Okay. Dit duurt langer, denk ik toch.
Want, kijk hoor, ze zitten nu al 3 minuten denk ik of zo in een call.
Ja, maar ik heb ze nu pas net die link gestuurd.
Ja, precies. Want we moeten natuurlijk ook nog... al die theorie zo meteen die grammatica doen.
Ja. Ja, we moeten maar... Op zich, de grammatica is niet super moeilijk.
Maar... Nee, oké.
Okay. Moet je me even stoppen als ik te lang aan het doorlullen ben.
Ja, we moeten gewoon voor zorgen dat we om 9 uur ongeveer pauze hebben.
Ja.
Dat moet wel lukken, denk ik.
Mm-hmm. En ik ga dan wel even echt in superspeed door de partijen heen.
Ja.
Ik zeg dat ze nog 3 minuten hebben.
Ja, is goed. Dat moet wel lukken, denk ik.
Zeg dat het breakout rooms werkt best wel goed. Ik ben tevreden, maar... Het enige vervelende is dat je niet mensen uit een room kan moven als ze er al in zitten en de room is open.
Ja. Ja.
Maar behalve dat, je kan gewoon echt naar iedereen een bericht sturen en zij kunnen... Je kan, als je dat doet, dan kan je ook... zien als zij een bericht in de chat sturen.
Maar je zag gewoon zeg maar, dat je een algemeen kan, of moet je wel per breakout room een bericht sturen?
Je hebt een knop en dat is make an announcement, dus dan kan je iedereen tegelijk een bericht sturen.
Oh, okay.
En als je dat doet, dan krijg je in de chat krijg je allemaal, zeg maar, gewoon die chats krijg je openstaan. En dan kan je naar elke ding een bericht sturen. Dus als zij een bericht sturen, dan kan ik het.
Ja, dat is inderdaad wel heel handig. Ja. Alleen dan met die andere groep, zeg maar, in de groepsapp was het over die breakout rooms of zo, dat sommigen niet konden doen of zo. Maar heeft er dan mee te maken dat studenten de chat beginnen, de ding beginnen?
Ja, nee, dat is inderdaad. Als je, dat kan alleen de organizer doen. Dat is echt het grootste downside. Dat maar één persoon breakout rooms kan doen. En ja. En dat kan maar één organizer zijn.
Ja, precies. Want ik kan dus ook geen breakout rooms doen.
Nee, dat is wel onhandig. Dat was gewoon, I guess, een limitatie van hoe ze dit gewoon hebben opgezet.
Ja. Maar misschien als
ik denk dat ze daar achter de schermen wel aan het werken zijn. Maar
ja, dat denk ik ook inderdaad hoor. Ja, als er een update komt, dan zal het wel veranderen.
Ik zie al een... ik zie de SP-mensen hebben een... zijn gewoon summaries in de dingen aan het gooien. De SP was a revolutionary syndicalist libertarian socialist party. It sought to end private ownership in general and combat the ruling class. Ik neem het aan dat dat niet van niet hun eigen woorden zijn.
Nee. Gewoon zo'n
exact party was een equal rights. Het zal also sought to combat alcoholism. Oké, wanneer zei ik 3 minuten? 35. Oké, dus nog 1 minuut. Dan zeg ik het nog 1 minuut.
Maar het gaat natuurlijk om wat ze in Nederland zoeken. Dus ik hoop en benieuwd of ze dan... Als ze in het Engels gaan zoeken, schiet het natuurlijk nog steeds niet echt op.
Nee, maar dan whatever.
Maar op zich hebben ze wel natuurlijk een kennis van politiek. Dus.
Ja, dat is ook belangrijk. Ja. Oh, ik stuurde uitroepteken more minute. Spam die chat helemaal vol.
Ja, het is nu ongeveer 38, dus ja...
Ja, ik heb ze nog even. Oké, dan kan ik alvast even dat ding openknallen.
Ja.
Ik heb een camera, heb ik. Oké, ja, ik heb het ding open hebben. Wat was, hoe heet het ook weer?
Tools.prodemos.
Ja.
Punt, ja.
Oeh. Oké, dan is het nu 39. Yanks eruit. Close the room. Ook iets anders, als je één room close, dan kan je ze niet allemaal weer tegelijk close. Dan moet je eerst. Oh. Dan kan je ze of individueel allemaal closen, of moet je alles weer opengooien en dan weer dichtgooien.
Oh, oké.
Onhandig.
Ja.
Maar whatever. Hallo, welcome back. Ik hoop dat jullie wat onderzoek hebben kunnen doen. Hope you were able to do some fine detective work. And then we will move on to the actual exercise, which is, where does my party belong on the axis? So I hope you did well, and I will just ask one of you from everything to tell me which bullet it's approximately. And also please mute your mic again if possible, otherwise I have to do it for you. And that comes across as rude. Okay, so from the VVD groep, the Partij voor Volkspartij voor Vrijheid en Democratie.
Die zijn de rest
inderdaad.
Best intensief. Hast du das noch? Das ist dann nur sehr interessant oder?
Ich habe noch ein bisschen was anderes, aber auch.
Cute. Okay, cool. So, Marina from groep VVD. Could you tell me which dot do you think the VVD is?
Well, we were confused because it says they're conservative liberals and they're also center-right. Mm-hmm. So maybe somewhere between rechts and conservative.
Okay, so which one do you think it is? Which dot?
The one near the middle.
This one?
Yeah, sure.
No, it is not. Want to venture another guess?
Are we in the right sphere?
You are in the right quadrant.
Okay. The one below it.
No, you get a thumbs. You serve the thumbs up if you get it right. You get one more chance.
The one up.
This one?
Yes.
Yeah, that's
the one. Yay!
Good. Of course, it's a very objective test, blah, 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 but in general, yeah, the VVD is pretty right-wing economically. But not as conservative as the other conservative parties, right-wing parties. So yes, good job. Okay, then team two, PVV. Jacqueline, where does the PVV land?
Yes. So as we were discussing, it's like a very conservative and right party. So I will vote like as an outlier. Let's say like this.
This one?
Yes.
Yep.
So I will say this, but.
Okay, but it is not, unfortunately.
Oh, okay.
Venture a second guess.
Ouch. So one less.
This one?
Yep. Okay. Yeah, so we just go one less again. Yeah. Because.
Nah, this is also a quirk of this system, but it judges the PV to be here.
Okay, really?
Yes. Yeah, they are.
Yeah, it's a bit. Yeah, they're a bit less because they're really about the Dutch norms and values, and they really want to take care of the Dutch health system and the education. They're really like the government has to do a lot for the Dutch people, but they're really conservative about the nationalities. But they're pretty much a bit more left when it comes to Dutch nationalities.
Okay.
Yeah, economic wise, they are a bit more left, but they are fairly conservative.
Yeah, that's why I vote for the outlier, because of all the conservatives and everything.
This was, I guess, one of the more tricky ones. So.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. But thanks. Okay, then team Seria. Jacob, would you?
We fought because it's fairly, it is a Christian conservative party, so we. It definitely has to be in the conservative half, but because they have kind of this green branding, we thought it would be more to the center. So, yeah, the closest one,
this one?
Would be our guess. Yeah.
Yeah, good job, indeed. Very good. Yeah, they are the Christian party, but they are not like the Christian party. They've gotten a lot less. Yeah. Probably the most, you have three Christian parties, which we'll talk about in a bit, but the one with, I guess, the least focus on that part. They're very, very center right party. Okay, cool. Going in one. Then, D66. Irene? Irene? I'm not sure if you prefer. Where do you think D66 lies?
Okay, we thought it was progressive right,
okay.
But there isn't any thought there.
Okay.
So we guess it's progressive. The one is the dot is there.
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah, very good. Indeed, they are pretty kind of centrist, right-ish economically, but they are pretty progressive. They are the reason, for instance, that the Netherlands has a pretty liberal euthanasia law. Then we have Team GroenLinks. Ariana, do you venture a guess where they belong?
Yeah, we're thinking in between progressive and links. So maybe to the up a bit.
This one?
Yes, maybe that one.
Yeah, got only one. Very good. That's a pretty difficult one to guess because they are all three like lie very similarly. But indeed, yeah, the green left. Likes left things and climate, doesn't like climate change. But.
And the Onderwijs and the Zorg.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Very
yeah.
Good. And then finally, Gabriella, I think. Yeah. You venture a guess for the SP?
Yeah. We believe it's. Can you hear me?
Is it where?
My connection is a little bit bad. It's progressive and links. Mm-hmm. So maybe the first dot. No, more in the mid-central, yeah.
Nope. It is not that one.
So in the second spot, like, yeah.
No, getting warmer.
So the outlier one.
This one.
Outside. No, the other one. Yeah.
No, also not. Unfortunately, it was this. here. They are probably, one of the most left-wing parties economically. They are the Socialist Party, but they're a bit less progressive in some areas. It's not like, I guess, they don't care about those issues, but they're less vocal about it. So that's why people put them here. All right. Then, so, good job. Hope you learned a little bit. Then we will, I will really try to be brief, go through the parties that are currently in the parliament with the names of the people. So this beautiful chart that I sort of made, it was very overzichtelijk, you can really see, but let's just focus on here for now. The parties in yellow are the ones in the current coalition and cabinet, the parties that have a majority of the seats in parliament and thus kind of run things at the moment. So it is the VVD, the Partij voor Volksvrijheid en Democratie, the People's Party of Freedom and Democracy. Het CDA, the Christian Democratic Appeal, D66, Democrats 66. En de ChristenUnie, the Christian Union. So they are here, D66, pretty progressive, sort of right-ish. Their spokesperson is Sigrid Kaag. VVD, you probably know this guy, Mark Rutte, he's the current prime minister. Pretty right. Then we have CDA. The current main guy is Wopke Hoekstra. And then we have the ChristenUnie, the kind of most left-leaning Christian party. But a bit more, I don't know, they don't like euthanasia. Gert-Jan Segers is his name. Then we will go on from top to bottom. PVV, the party from Geert Wilders. This is Geert Wilders, and he is the party. This is a single person party. Everyone else is just a volunteer. He's the only person in the party, and he just basically controls what the party does. Very weird. Really hates Islam. Ooh, he really doesn't like it, and the EU and immigrants. Then we have, maybe I should also say something about this. VVD likes markets. CDA likes farmers. D66 likes education. Then we have GroenLinks. Main guy is Jesse Klaver. They don't like climate change, but that's kind of their main focus. And just environment in general and leftist things. SP, they are, main talking points are like, no eigen risico, so the thing you pay before your insurance kicks in, basically. Lower retirement age, general leftist things, but then like the leftist version of it. Then we have PvdA, the Partij voor de Arbeid, the party, the Labour Party. Currently led by Liliana Ploemen. Kind of like the SP, but then a bit less left. Notable that they lost like 30 seats last election. They just got gutted because they were in the coalition together with the VVD, which is kind of a weird mix. Then we have the ChristenUnie. Can we say that? A bit more Christian than CDA, a bit more in favor of a bit more left-wing, but not that much. And then we have the PVDD, the Partij voor de Dieren. Led by Esther Ouwehand at the moment. The Animal Party is for animals against climate change, sort of left, became a bit broader over time, but still seen as kind of a one-issue party. You have the SGP, the conservative, the Staatsgereformeerde Partij, oldest party in Netherlands, only party that exists pre-World War II, just always get three seats or two, because they just have the same people voting on them. I don't want to reinstate the death penalty, are very Christian. Then Denk, these guys, led by, I knew his name, Azarkan. I don't forget his first name, I'm very sorry.
Yeah.
Split off of the PvdA, pretty similar, more of a focus on like more equal society, pro-immigration. Strong-ish ties to Turkey, which they get criticized for. I don't know that much about them. Then we have 50 plus. They are for old people. Led by, I knew her name. Fuck. Liana something. She's new. the older person, Henk Krol, he left the party, started a new party, and then got kicked out of that party and then made another party, which he's currently running from. Well, we'll see how long that lasts. Then Forum for Democracy, you might have seen this guy's face, Thierry Baudet, very against EU and climate change people, wants more participation in democracy, currently the biggest party in the Senate. And then that was it. Okay, we did it. It only took twice as long as we thought it would. But now you are more up to speed with the Dutch political system. These parties are running, there are more parties running, and they will fight off next week. And if you can vote, go vote. If you can't, then yell about it. Cool. Okay, we made it.
Okay.
Maybe it's good if we do the break now.
Yeah, and then move on to other things. Yeah.
We do actually have a Dutch in this lesson, don't worry. So let us have a break until 9, briefly. Yeah, 9, that's the word. And then we go through some stuff, and then have you do a stuff, and then we're done. Sound right? Okay.
Yes.
And we'll be here if you have any questions. All right.
Can I ask, what was the party in the bottom right?
Yeah. Forum for Democracy. Forum for Democracy is their name.
Oh, FVD?
FVD, yes.
You said it's the biggest party in the Senate, but not.
Yes. They are very new, started in 2016, and only got 2 seats in the parliamentary elections in 2017. And then in the Senate election or provincial election 2019, they got like 14 seats in the Senate, okay. Which only has 17.
I've seen that guy's face a lot, I feel like.
Yeah, he's pretty in
controversial, right?
Yeah, yeah, very controversial. Yeah.
I feel like he also just like really doesn't like women or something. Like, I feel like he said some sexist stuff as well.
Yeah. Yeah, his party had a pretty big falling out because the youth faction had a lot of anti-Semitic messages going on. Okay. And so the party actually kind of split up, and now we have 2 of them. And one is a little less anti-Semitic.
Okay. But it's like low on the list for the parliament.
Yeah. At the moment, it only has 2 seats, but I think they'll get quite a bit.
Yeah, more. So next week, the elections, they are expecting to get probably maybe 2 more seats, I thought. So they will probably go up in the seats in the parliament.
Okay. Well, that sucks.
Yeah, but they have a lot of controversy.
And none of the big parties wants to make a coalition with them. So when VVD becomes the biggest party and it meets some other parties, Mark Rutte has said he doesn't want to work with the Forum for Democracy, so
yeah.
That's kind of good. Yeah.
Same as with Geert over here. He's the second biggest party, but no one wants to rule with him.
No one wants to play with him.
No, no one wants to play with Geert.
But what about the controversy with Mark Rutte? Like the whole, because right now there's technically no government, right? Is that still a thing?
Yeah.
Yes. It was a pretty big, we're going to have some more things, but the recent biggest thing was that the government, more specifically the tax, the IRS basically, was labeling people as doing fraud a lot for getting money for child's, what's the word?
Yeah.
And like a lot, they're like 100,000 euros. Hounded them for like a long time, and it took a really long time for anyone to do anything about. It had been running since this government started, or even earlier. And so it didn't really look good for anyone. And so the government fell.
Yeah.
Because yeah, they just like, okay, yeah, it's not working. And normally then elections would be sooner because there's no government, but because the elections were so close anyway, it didn't really matter.
Do you think they're still going to have the most seats? Like, it's not going to affect it?
Well, yeah, at the moment they are projected to get even more seats than they have now. So
yeah. Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the one thing that Rutte does well is just immune to fucking controversy. So, like a couple of years ago, he also was also what was the thing? Yeah, the government cut the cuts dividend tax, mm-hmm. like tax that you pay on top of the money that you give to shareholders. Yeah. And people said that that was because Unilever and Shell were going to move their headquarters from London to Amsterdam or the or Rotterdam, whatever. Rutte was like, nah, he worked at Unilever for 10 years, pretty high up. And he was like, nah, that was not the case. And then people found documents that said, oh yeah, this is definitely the case. And he was like, oh yeah, I kind of just forgot that that happened, I guess. Or for who knew? But that did nothing, I guess, to his popularity. So. He slipped.
Well, we'll see again.
Oké, Thomas, gaan we het dan wel redden zo met die kieswijze kunnen dan denk ik niet doen dat we nog dat in die verdeling, Tweede Kamerverdeling. Nee,
dat gaan we dan, de verdeling skippen we dan even.
Ja, dan doen we gewoon maar, een kwartiertje of zo.
Ja, even poweren door het grammatica en dan...
ja.
Dat is altijd wat we doen. Dat we niet in... misschien is het goed om niet... Nee, dat moeten we wel even mentionen. Oké, okay, we kunnen het als 10 minuten comparatives, 5 minuten wel en niet.
Oké, okay. Ja, dat moet wel lukken. Die, bijvoorbeeld naamwoorden kennen ze sowieso al best wel goed, denk ik dan, toch?
Dat ja, goed. We moeten gewoon even mentionen dat die op die E moet letten.
Ja, precies. Oké. Okay. Ja, is goed.
Got it.
Oké, spannend.
Mm-hmm. En ik denk dat we gewoon even voor die groepschat, dat gaat ook te lang niet anders, gewoon even in de mail sturen of zo.
Ja, dat is een beetje idee, ja.
Well, ik denk dat de andere leraren dat ook nog niet hebben gedaan.
Nee.
Misschien gewoon een grote mail erover sturen.
Ja. Ja, hier in dit afstelsel zie je dan wel weer die plekken van PVV is hier weer heel anders en D66 ook.
Ja, inderdaad.
Dus nou ja, het ligt er net aan welk standpunt ze op een bepaald moment innemen, wat actueel is natuurlijk ook.
Mm-hmm. Ja, en ook hoeveel gewicht je geeft aan elk standpunt. Oh, ook dat. Oké, okay, let us begin.
Yes, let's begin. Okay, so we'll go through some grammatica pretty quickly. So I'll start with the adjectives, bijvoeglijke naamwoorden. You probably know some about it. You place it between the article and the noun, So de is the article here and stoel is the noun. So mooi is the adjective. But you have to add an e because of the rules. We'll come to that next slide. But you basically place the adjective between the article and the noun to say something about the noun, to give a characteristic or just to describe the noun. And when there's is in the sin, so the stool is, so the verb is, you place the adjective behind is. The stool is mooi. This is the basic placement, then how to make it. When you have the articles de and het, you always add an e after the adjective. So the mooie stoel. So mooi is the basic adjective, and because it's de stoel, you add an e. And also and plurals are also de woorden, because they're both de boeken. So de mooie boeken, because it's de. Then when we have een, that's the indefinite article. When een is a replacement for the article de, so een mooie stoel, you just add an e. So een mooie stoel. But when een is a replacement for het, you add nothing. It's just the basic adjective, so no e. So een mooi boek. So that's a big difference. When een replaces het, you do nothing. But when een replaces de, you add an e. That's the main rule. And after is, there also is nothing. So the stoel is mooi. So it's not the stoel is mooie, just the basic adjective. That's how to make it. And then some spelling rules. Well, we have the same problem here like last week with the vowels and the verbs. So groot, that's groot has a long vowel. And in this case, there are two O's and one consonant, a T. So we want to remove one of the vowels, the O, because it already has a long vowel. So instead of two O's, we just remove one. So it becomes de grote stoel. But the other example, there is a short vowel, dik. It's not dik, it's dik. And because of this short vowel, we add another consonant to, well, just give it more body or something like that. So we make a double K. So het dikke boek. Or for example, de dun, the opposite of dik, dun is also short. So het dunne boek, you add two, make two N's. So that's also something to remind with long vowels and short vowels. And then we also have the problem with the S and the Z and the V and F and V. We do not want to have an F or an S at the end, endish. So lieve, we replace the F and we make it a V. And wijs, we do not want to have the S, we want to have the Z. So een wijze vrouw instead of wijze vrouw. Yeah, these are, I think, the main. And when we have materials, for example, the wooden fence, het houten hek, materials always get en. So instead of houten, we make houten, because wood, hout, is a material. I have this golden necklace, and that's made of gold, so gouden ketting, goud and then en. And when we have after is, het hek is van hout. You place van, because it says what it's made of, van. And then just the basic adjective, hout. So it's not van houten, het hek is van houten, maar het hek is van hout. That's what you do with materials. So just remember to add, in most cases, add an E when you make an adjective. And there are some exceptions. For example, when het becomes een. And remember the long and short vowels and the materials.
Yes.
That's a short overview of the adjectives. Then we'll go to the trappen van vergelijking. So comparatives and superlatives. The first level is the stellende trap. It's positive, is the positive. And it's kind of the same, it's basically just the adjective. It's not, nothing really changes. The rules for adjective are just also apply. So Nederland is een klein land. Een klein land. Het is het land. And het becomes een, so een klein land. And therefore klein stays the same. So no e at the end. In all the other cases, it's just like the adjective. The stellende trap, nothing really happens. Also with een knappe lijsttrekker, you see here, knap is a short vowel. So you double the consonant P, een knappe lijsttrekker. And it stellende trap just says something about the noun, just like the adjective. Nothing really. You're not saying something is more or less, it's just, you're just saying something about a noun. Next slide, I think. Yeah. And you can also make comparisons with the stijl en de trap. But it's what I said, it's not about more or less. It's even. They're on the same level. Something is just as important as the other thing. So het klimaat is net zo belangrijk als de economie. Here you can see that belangrijk, that's the adjective in this case, just stays the same. It's nothing is happening. There's no more, no other rules, just because it's on the same level. You're comparing them, but the other is not more important than climate, is not more important than economy. You think they are on the same. They are just as important as.
Yes.
So that's the stijl en de trap. It's just a basic adjective, actually.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Evelien, laten we de stembuizen als huiswerk doen.
Ja, oké. All
right.
Some short examples. Maybe Thomas to the end. Yeah, naar het einde.
Yeah.
Just you can see here mooie tafel because it is een tafel and it's de tafel, so an I after mooie. Dan net zo warm als gisteren. You're making de stijl en de trap, so net zo. They're on the same level, just so warm stays the same. Nothing is changing. Dan ik ben mijn dikke jas vergeten. Here you see mijn dikke jas. It's de jas. And dik is a short vowel, so you're making the consonant, you're doubling the consonant. Dikke jas. And then the last one. Wat een goed idee. Idee is een het woord. Het idee. And you're replacing het with een. So goed stays goed. No I at the end. Een goed idee. Dus niet een goede idee, maar een goed idee.
Yes, very good. But now I hear you say, but Thomas, what if I don't want to say things are just as good? I just want to say things are better or worse. This is politics. I want to have a strong opinion about things. Well, then we come to the vergrotende trap, the enlarging stair, comparatives, way easier. So, comparatives in Dutch, pretty easy, pretty similar to English. You just add er to the end of the adjective instead of an e. Instead of nothing. So here, predicative, de opkomst is dit jaar misschien kleiner. So the amount of people who will vote might be smaller this year, kleiner, because of corona probably. In front of een or without an article, grotere partijen zitten vaak in de coalitie. Bigger parties are often in the coalition. A more trustworthy cabinet would not have fallen, referring to the government falling this like a month ago. So a more trustworthy cabinet would not have fallen. I think I said that. And here we see that indeed, if it is, the comparative just works the same as the adjective with rules, only you just add an ER. And then afterwards you add the E or you don't, according to the same rules. So with het, kabinet is een het word, het kabinet. This is a comparative, betrouwbaarder, more trustworthy. And we don't add an E because it is a het word and it is een. So, but here, grotere partijen, de partijen is een de word, but there is no article, so it is the same as een. And then we have groter is bigger, and then grotere is bigger again. With a definite article, you always have an E, no matter if it's de or het. So de kleinere partijen moeten knokken om een zetel. The smaller parties have to fight to get a seat. Or het besmettelijkere virus verspreidt zich sneller. The more contagious virus spreads faster. In Dutch, spreads itself faster. And that construction we'll get to in less than 5 from the top of my head. Yes. So again, note the vowel, etc. But this time it always happens. You always have to think of it because the ER will always add vowel, consonant vowel, almost always, actually. Almost always. So groot becomes groter, snel becomes sneller. you know, it is very similar to English, but it just has an E sometimes. If you want to compare things, you can use the comparative dan, which means than, with an A. So Koning Willem Alexander is ouder than Koningin Maxima. King Willem Alexander is older than Queen Maxima. It's true. And you just use is done. Is adjective or then. Just like in English. Very difficult. And you don't have to use is, by the way. You can also say Koning Willem Alexander vecht slechter dan Koningin Maxima. Fights worse than Queen Maxima. He doesn't look like much of a fighter, you know? Then we come to the overtreffende trap. The, I don't know how to translate that literally, the superlative. You just add ST or an E. So just like in English, but in English it is EST, and thus it is ST sometimes E. So here, predicatively, Wilders is het blondst in de Tweede Kamer. Geert Wilders is the blondest person in the second chamber. There is no st with an indefinite article because you don't have a most of something. You can't say, oh yeah, I just want a best computer. No, you have the best computer. There's no a best computer. The only examples are things where the ist and whatever is compounded into a noun. Like you can have a strongest man because the strongest man is like a competition, you know? But otherwise there are no really examples of this. Here with the definite article, de VVD is de grootste partij. De VVD is the biggest party. Or de meeste mensen stemmen. Most people vote. Interestingly, most people is not is indefinite in English and definite in Dutch. De meeste mensen stemmen. How do you, yeah, you can't really compare that because you don't compare. You could just say he is the best or they are the best. And that is just final. Sometimes in Dutch, we use meest, most, in front of the superlative because otherwise the word sounds weird. Note that we don't do that with the comparative. So we don't say more something something like you do in English when a word gets kind of long and difficult. So in Dutch, you would say for enthusiastic. So I am, ik ben enthousiast, I'm enthusiastic. Zij is enthousiaster, she is more enthusiastic, enthusiastiker. But you don't say hij is het enthousiast. Because that's really awkward. So you just say, hij is het meest enthousiast. Also with this word like logisch, logist. So things that end in S and a T or an E, those don't, you just put most in front of it. It doesn't really have that much to do with how long the word is, but a little bit. Meest timide, you don't say timidest. That doesn't sound right. Most timid, which is a real competition, of course, where people really care about. Just like in English, we have some irregular forms, words that behave a little bit differently than they do, like you would think they are. So these are adjectives like goed, graag, veel, and weinig. So good, rather, like to, difficult word, much or many, and little or few. So in Dutch, we don't distinguish between countable and uncountable nouns. Very easy. So we just have veel and minder, veel and weinig. So a lot and not a lot. We don't have like much and many. Like you can have veel water and veel keyboards. Doesn't matter if it's countable or not. So for goed, it is goed, beter, best, good, better, best. Wow, very original. For graag, so graag is like to, something like that. Liever is would prefer to, and liefst is would really like to. I would like it the most. Ik wil het liefst een groene auto. I would like to have a green car the most. It is a bit of a weird word, but it's very useful. It indicates preference. Veel means a lot. So veel, meer, meest. Yeah, just a lot, more, many, most. And weinig. Not a lot. Less. least or fewest. Wow. Now you learned about comparatives. Good job. And now, for the first time ever, let's actually do an exercise. Let's just do it, you know? Let's actually just go to the booklet and write things down the way God intended. Okay, so for this exercise, exercise one, I think I'll just put you in groups again so you can discuss about things. You don't have to, but it will be useful because sometimes you get stuck with a word. So ignore each other around, but I would prefer you not to. You have to translate the sentences. No, you don't have to. You just have to fill in the correct adjective and the correct, sometimes like comparative phrase, like even als or the word done sometimes. So figure out what it is. If you have extra time, please translate the sentence. If you don't, that's fine. But just figure out what the right word is. You'll be with the three of you. So I'll give you like 5 to 10 minutes. I will let you know like 2 minutes before if you stop. Okay? Do you have any questions before that? No? Know that you can always type the questions in the chat when you're in the breakout rooms. I can see that. Let's see what you're doing. Okay? Good luck. Oh, timing. Horrible.
Yeah, it works.
Nice.
Okay.
Well, het zou goed in op tijd zijn.
Nou, laten we ze hebben denk ik de tijd tot, nou, wat zal het zijn? 10:30 of zo? Nee, hoe heet dat? 5:30 denk ik.
Ja, dat vind ik wel een goede tijd.
Ja. En gaan we het dan bespreken of dat doen we volgende week?
Ik zou het wel even bespreken, maar dan de helft of zo. Want we doen het nooit.
Ja,
tenminste, nou, dat is niet waar, want we hebben op één les gedaan.
Maar... Hey, Thomas.
Oh, hey. Oh, you're not in the group.
I was, but my computer went crazy and then I went out. I don't know how.
Oh, okay. Which, you're in group 2? Okay, wait. Yeah, so I have to yank out your friend again and then put you both back in. Sorry, okay. That's just how it works. Thank it's you. Really annoying.
Sorry.
Yeah. So it's closing. Okay, hey Jacob, sorry, but Lucia had some trouble, so we need to do the group.
Sorry.
That's how it works. Okay, and
hey.
There you go again. You can already look at the exercise.
Yeah, I'm already doing it.
Great. And there you go. Yeah, okay, cool.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, cool.
Top. Oké, okay. Nou mooi. Dan geven ze gewoon, ja, die kieswijze kunnen ze dan gewoon zelf invullen als ze willen.
Ja, dan wat ik misschien kan doen is dat we dan zo'n... wel die poll erin gooien en als, dat die anoniem kan zijn, hopelijk. Als dat kan, anders niet. En dan kunnen we misschien de volgende les beginnen met kijken hoe de Tweede Kamer eruit zou zien als wij het voor zich hadden. Want dat taait ook wel goed in, want dan is ook de verkiezing.
Ja, precies. Ja, dat is wel leuk inderdaad om te doen.
Weet je ook wie jij gaat stemmen?
Ik vind het heel lastig. Ik weet niet. Van die kieswijzers weet ik, ik vind dat ook gewoon, ik heb al die dingen al een keer ingevuld, maar ja, dan komt er elke keer weer net iets anders uit, of ik zit nog wel een beetje te twijfelen.
Mm. Maar, ja, ik vind het ook moeilijk. Het voelt ook niet helemaal juist voor mij om mijn beslissing helemaal op zo'n kieswijzer te doen, ook al nee. Doe ik niet zoveel meer onderzoek daarnaast, maar...
Nee, klopt, ik vind dat ook heel lastig en het is, ja, weet je... Ik op bepaalde standpunten van een partij vind ik dan heel goed, maar ook weer van een andere partij. Dat als ik denk, gewoon, als die twee bij elkaar zouden als een paar standpunten van gewoon één partij zouden vormen, mm-hmm. Dan zou ik daarop stemmen. Maar weet je, ik vind dat heel lastig.
Mm-hmm.
Dus hopelijk krijg ik binnen een week een ingeving.
Ja. Zou je het heel erg vinden om op de ene partij te stemmen en niet op de andere?
Ja, nou, het is meer waar geef ik nu voorkeur aan, want sommige partijen... Kijk, maar je moet een beetje aan de toekomst denken natuurlijk, vind ik. Dus ga ik voor een partij stemmen die echt inzet op klimaat. En, maar ja, bijvoorbeeld stel je gaat meer op een linkspartij die wat meer klimaat inzet. Ik ben dan weer niet per se voor dat heel veel bedrijven, of dat er heel veel meer belasting moet betaald worden door bedrijven en zo. Dat vind ik dan weer niet. Dus zeg maar, dat vind ik een beetje lastig. Ja. Dus daar heb ik een beetje mee.
Ja, dan is het inderdaad wel weer lastig. Ik guess dan D66 is closed.
Ja.
Zo zijn er.
Ja, dat is zeker waar. Ja, D66 is wel mijn ze kan te denken. En op zich. Maar ik ga ook best wel snel op de persoon, zeg maar. Als ik gewoon een leuk persoon vind. En als ik de lijsttrekker gewoon een leuk persoon vind, dan ga je daar al snel een beetje op af, weet je wel.
Ja.
Heb je
niet zoveel met Sigrid Kaag?
Nou, ik vind haar niet echt voor de politiek, zeg maar. Zij is meer een diplomaat. Ik vind haar niet echt een. Ik weet niet. Ik vind haar niet echt goed in. Zij is heel erg neutraal, zo, snap ik wat ik bedoel? Ze is heel erg.
Dus ze komt niet echt heel erg sterk. Like,
precies. Ze is niet echt voor haar mening of zo. Het komt niet heel sterk over. Dus ze is heel neutraal en. Ja, ik weet niet. Ik weet niet of dat goed is voor echt voor in de politiek. Ik denk dat zij meer een ambtenaarachtig, meer ja, diplomatie en zo is.
Mm-hmm.
Dus daar zit ik een beetje mee.
Okay.
Maar ik wil wel op zich wel meer vrouwen of zo in de Tweede Kamer. Dus misschien dat ik gewoon op een vrouwelijke lijst, dat ik een voorkeurstem uitbreng of zo.
Mm-hmm.
Ja. Nee. Maar ik ben benieuwd, volgende week.
Ik heb geen idee hoe het.
Nee, want het gaat sowieso natuurlijk weer. Ik denk dat het wel weer uit 5 partijen moet bestaan, de coalitie. Want...
Ja, ik denk dat dit keer echt het meeste wacky gaat
zijn. Maar dan ga je natuurlijk nog meer, dan gaat het nog langer duren voor de besluiten worden genomen en zo.
Ja. En de coalitievorming vorig jaar duurde al best wel lang.
Daarom, dat duurde echt wel. Nou ja, in september, toen echt een half jaar later of zo was het pas. Maar dat kan nu met corona mogen ze wel een beetje opschieten dan hoor.
Mm-hmm, ja.
Dus ja.
Maar ja, ik zie het ook niet, want ik bedoel, de VVD krijgt waarschijnlijk hoop stemmen, maar...
Ja.
Ik heb het gevoel dat D66 niet echt per se veel stemmen krijgt.
Nee.
Ik denk dat ze super populair, dat ze zich zo populair hebben gemaakt.
Ik denk dat heel veel mensen het gewoon bij Mark Rutte houden ook, omdat ze gewoon vooral vanwege corona, denk ik, dat ze gewoon laat hem het maar gewoon afmaken, weet je wel, zo.
Mm-hmm.
Dus dat denk ik, ja.
Ja, dat is gewoon veel nieuws. Dat helpt ook
dat, wel. Ja, met de persconferentie natuurlijk altijd.
Ook al is die per se positief. Mensen weten wie hij is en weten niet wie Lilian van 50PLUS is. Ik weet niet eens wat haar naam is.
Ja, nou precies, ja. Nee, klopt. Dus nou ja. Oké, nog 1 minuut denk ik, ja.
Ja, ik had ze iets langer geven.
Oké.
Om het dan weg kort.
Oh, we moeten ook nog ontkenningen zo meteen even snel door.
Ja.
Oh.
Net ik snel.
Maar het is wel goed zeg maar, dat we lang stil zijn bij de politiek. Want dat is, ik denk dat het is natuurlijk wel leuker om daarover te hebben dan over grammatica. En die grammatica kunnen ze natuurlijk zelf dan ook een beetje in een booklet opzoeken en zo. En ja, als er een vraag over hebben, kan ik volgende week kunnen ze vragen nog over stellen. Als ze het echt dieper op in willen of zo.
Al denk ik dat we misschien, ik denk iets te lang over de politiek.
Ja, oké, misschien iets te lang.
Ja, ik zag wel dat mensen een beetje wat minder actieve houding.
Oké, ja.
Zetten. Maar dat is ook wel prima. Dus tenminste een beetje geëducateerd door, dat is een woord, sowieso.
Ja. En die hebben ze wel een beeld bij.
Ja. Een beeld.
Een beeld, ja.
Nou, ik ben benieuwd wat dat. Ik moet zeggen, ik ben er niet heel erg involved. Ik was veel meer. Ik denk dat de Amerikaanse verkiezingen me een beetje hebben. Een beetje fed up. Nee, niet fed up, maar meer een beetje overexposed hebben naar politiek nieuws.
Ja.
En dat ik nu een beetje van vergeleken met de Amerikaanse partijen zijn de Nederlandse partijen gewoon zoveel redelijker. Dat is ook een stuk minder.
Ja, ik snap wat je bedoelt. Ja, ja, ja. Ja. Ja, het is sowieso natuurlijk het Nederlands politiek systeem sowieso gewoon best wel met 37 partijen nu. Dat is gewoon heel veel.
In Amerika is insane.
Gewoon, Amerika heeft gewoon twee keuzes en hier heb je gewoon zoveel meer.
37 ook, ja.
Ja, dat is echt niet normaal.
Dat is zoveel. Dat is wel een beetje te veel.
Ja.
Maar ja, ik weet niet. Waarschijnlijk hebben we maar... ligt aan hoeveel mensen we in de... Hoeveel partijen zouden in de kamer komen, denk je? 15? Ik denk dat ja 21 wel nieuw in de kamer komt.
Ja, ik denk dat er best veel één persoon zeteltjes komen.
Gewoon. Ja, ik denk dat Volt wel een kans heeft.
Ja.
Bij één ook wel.
Ja. Code Oranje heb je ook wel, die een goede kans maakt.
Oh, daar heb ik helemaal niet van gehoord. Moet ik zeggen.
En Boer-Burgerbeweging.
Oh ja.
Ook nog.
Okay,
en ja 21, dat denk ik ook nog wel.
Ja. Yeah. Oké, okay. Close the rooms. Ja, nu onderbreek ik ze wel in het midden van het gesprek, maar whatever. Hallo, welkom back. Sorry for rudely interrupting your deep, deep thoughts. I didn't feel like sending a warning. Welcome. How did it go? Did it go well? Some pained faces. We'll see. Okay, let us quickly go through this because important quickly. So I'm just going to tell you the answers. Let's go. Okay, so first, mijn Nederlands is dan haar Nederlands. And then you would say, it is beter dan haar Nederlands, because we have a dan in there. So it is beter dan. So my Dutch is better than her Dutch. Ha, take that, her. And two, de spreker is veel dan hem. De spreker is veel overtuigender dan hem. The speaker is much more convincing than he is. Or than him. De SP is de rijkste partij van Nederland. Oh. Dat is de answer. De rijkste partij van Nederland. With the most money. Four. Dus de SP is the richest part of Nederland. Because they have a lot of contribution. Whatever. Four. Geert Wilders wil Marokkanen. Geert Wilders wil minder Marokkanen. It's a reference to a very controversial statement by Geert Wilders. Wanting less Moroccans in the Netherlands. And it's relevant, because it has a comparative in it. 5. D66 en CDA hebben allebei 19 zetels. D66 is even groot als CDA. Yes. So D66 en CDA both have 19 seats. D66 is just as big as CDA. Next. Again, feel free to interrupt. Although I don't want to make it seem like you are free to interrupt, you are free to interrupt.
You said the one about Geert Wilders has veil in the brackets.
Yes.
Isn't that more?
It is indeed. Yeah, it's indeed wrong. It should say weinig. You're totally right. So.
Okay, I thought it was a joke. Like, you know.
Yes. Oh no! Totally. Yeah. No, you're right. Totally was a joke.
Okay.
Meer. That would be way better than what I had. En dat is totally what I meant. Cool. Good comment. 6. Op welke partij stem jij het graag? Het liefst. Op welke partij stem jij het liefst? On which party do you do most like to vote? Kind of a weird sentence. 7. Ik vind de FVD de ChristenUnie. Ik vind de FVD radicaler dan de ChristenUnie. I think Forum for Democracy is more radical than the Christian Union. Very radical party. De Christian Union. 8. 2021 wordt een jaar dan 2020. Leuker. 2021 will be a more fun year than 2020. Oh. Mark Rutte is niet als Jesse Klaver. Mark Rutte is niet zo snel als Jesse Klaver. He isn't as fast as Jesse Klaver. He would totally not beat him in a foot race. Niet zo groen, isn't so as green as is Klaver. Then, hoe je leest, hoe makkelijk het is om te stemmen. Hoe meer je leest, hoe minder makkelijk het is om te stemmen. The more you read, the more difficult it is to make up your mind on who to vote, is the implied thing, even though it doesn't really sound like that. All right. Those were the comparatives. How did that go? Did you have any questions? Any other comments? Oh, it was all perfect and very understandable. Great.
I have a question actually for the soul snail, a groen. How do they relate?
Oh no, that is a typo in the answer. It should be zo groen. I don't know. I think those are answers from the. I changed these to be politically related at some point, and I think the original answer was so snail, and I didn't change it.
What was supposed to be instead of groen?
Oh, it is supposed to be zo groen. Yeah, Mark Rutte is niet zo groen als Jesse Klaver. He isn't as green, like, politically, as Jesse Klaver.
Ah, thank you.
I think skin tone-wise, there are pretty similar levels of greenness. And I don't know how fast they are, unfortunately. Maybe we should just do that as a election. Just have a foot race, 100 meters. Who gets there first gets the most votes. All right, then. Let's just do this later. I can't talk about negations at half 10. That's, I don't think that will enter your brain in any sensible way. This is the end of the class. A bit premature, but that's fine. We had something else planned to do as a final exercise, but that would take too much time, and it is good to do some actual Dutch exercises instead of just read about politics, because you already did that a bit. What you can do as homework is, first of all, fill in this. I'll put the link somewhere, but I'll put it again. It is the kieswijzer, the stemwijzer. So it's like a voting direction. You answer questions in Dutch about political statements and if you agree with them or not. And then at the end, it will tell you which party suits you the best. Interesting to do. And most important, it's good Dutch practice because the questions are in Dutch. Maybe we will collect votes in some anonymous way at the start of the next lesson and then see how our parliament would look if we could pick. But that is predicated upon us being able to find a good way to collect votes anonymously, because not always nice to just type in your political opinions everywhere, you know? So we'll see about that. But otherwise, there's also normal homework for people who don't want to do other things. The first is just a nice comparative exercise, and the other is a weird bonus exercise. And it is bonus, so you don't have to do it. So only if you like doing this. This is very good Dutch practice, I think. It is watch the next episode. I think it is the final one of Zondag met Lubach, Dutch talk show, kind of like late Sunday night with John Oliver, Dutch John Oliver. Like 30 minutes things. Always has a big segment at the end. Of that big segment, try to write a short summary in Dutch as best as you can. The episode is in Dutch. They sometimes have that English subtitles at some point, but they don't at the start. So it will be very difficult. But it will be very good exercise, I think, should you choose to accept it. Otherwise, there is Duolingo, of course. You should have gotten a notification at somewhere. It is politics one, comparatives, and the negatives. You can do that. And if you do it, if you do some of them at least, you'll get a little thumbs up from old Thomas. Okay. Are there any questions?
Do we have access to these PowerPoints?
Oh.
Do we have access to these PowerPoints or no?
Yes, this PowerPoint will come online. I didn't do that last time, but I will do that this time. I will put them in the general, in the files tab of the general channel. And maybe also this channel, but check in the general because I'll definitely do it there. Okay. Also, this lesson will be rewatchable online if you're interested. Okay. No other questions? Great. Then, I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Hope you learned something. Hope you also learned a little bit of Dutch, maybe. And then we'll see you next time where we'll talk about work. Yeah. Okay. Tot volgende week. Vanavond.
Tot volgende week.
Tot volgende week. Doei.
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 Doei. Doei.
Doei.
Doei. Doei. Cool.
Oké, top. Nou, dan moeten we kijken hoe het om met die ontkenningen, of we dat nog ergens een keer gaan tussenproppen. Of...
Ja, het is wel goed om een keer te mentionen. Op zich, ik weet niet of het ook... Ze hebben het al een keer gezien, sowieso. Ze gaan de Duolingo-ding doen, hopelijk.
Ja.
En er is... wat is er nog meer? Nee, dat was het. En we kunnen het nog wel even een keer mentionen. Het is niet super moeilijk. Oh, en dat was andere. Het is nog niet super nuttig om erover te hebben, omdat ze nog niet echt over woordvolgorde hebben gepraat.
Ja, klopt, ja.
Dus misschien dat voor woordvolgorde, die is nu op zich een beetje leeg. Omdat die zou normaal in deze les moeten. Ook nog.
Oké,
ja. Zo optimistisch als ik voor het
Dan kunnen we ontkenningen gewoon daarbij nog even benoemen, bij die woordvoering.
Ja, dat is gewoon bij vier les. Dat past best wel goed. Er is op zich dan niet zo heel erg veel anders te doen. Maar daar moet nog een leesopdracht bij.
Oké.
Okay. Dat had ik niet bedacht. Of wel? Ik weet niet. Ik had denk ik iets gezet in het boekje.
Dat zou best kunnen. Moeten we even kijken, ja.
Oké.
Ja. Oké, okay, top. Nou. Ook weer gezien.
Zou jij misschien of een mail of willen draften of een bericht hierin willen sturen over de WhatsApp groep?
Ja, is het handig? Ja, wat is handig via de mail dat we.
Ik denk dat via de mail beter is, omdat mensen waarschijnlijk niet Teams checken.
Nee, en dan. Maar heb ik dan al hun mailadressen of moet ik dan? Hoe moet dat dan?
Je kan het naar.
Lucy?
Op de drive hebben we een.
Oh ja.
Hebben we die absentieformulieren die we definitely gebruiken?
Ja.
En daar staan... invullen. We kunnen terugkijken wie in de les was, zeg maar. Dus dat
ja.
Prima.
En staat daar ook gewoon de indeling van onze.
Er staan alle e-mails bij en die kan gewoon copy-pasten.
Oh, oké. Okay. Dus ook van klas 10, zeg maar. Oké, okay, top. Dan doe ik dat en dan vraag ik ze gewoon om een nummer terug te mailen, denk ik. Dat is makkelijkst. Mm-hmm.
Ja, ja, en mention dat wij er niet direct in gaan.
Nee, precies. Ja, oké.
Okay. Het enige nadeel aan wat ik aan de mail zie... Nou, er zou ook andere mogelijkheden zijn. Dat ze niet kunnen zien wat andere mensen doen.
Oh, op die manier.
Ja, want het is wel motiverend, zeg maar, als je ziet dat andere mensen het doen, dan ben je wel...
Op zich als... Op zich, als je het zeg maar allemaal naar alle mensen stuurt, dan zien ze wel dat het naar meerdere mensen is gestuurd of zo.
Ja, ja, dus... ik denk niet dat er een goede manier is om dat te doen als we niet zeg maar iedereen's mailnummer willen laten zien. Tenzij ze de... Nou oké, doe.
Ik vraag het wel gewoon, anders kan je er woensdag nog op terugkomen van degene die... Dat je gewoon zegt, er zijn nu zoveel mensen in de groep, degene die nog willen aansluiten, kunnen nog een nummer sturen. Zoiets. Ja. Ja, okay.
Oh nee, wacht, WhatsApp heeft nu veel beter iets hiervoor. We kunnen gewoon een groep maken en ik ga een link sturen.
Oh ja.
Veel beter.
Oh ja, ja, dat is waar ook.
Ja. Dat is lekker maar zo.
Dan sturen we gewoon een link in de mail.
Ja, en plaatsen maar ook op Teams.
Oké, okay. Is goed. Ja. Dan is goed. Zal ik het morgen even naar kijken.
Mm-hmm.
Top. Oké, okay, nou, dan wens ik jou volgende week succes, want zie ik jou niet?
Ja.
En over 2 weken weer. Nou, laat weten hoe het is gegaan volgende week.
Zal ik doen. En top. Succes met... wat ga je doen eigenlijk? Stemmen tellen?
Ja, of? Ik denk dat ik moet gaan desinfecteren of zo. Dat ik potloden moet desinfecteren.
Oh man, dat is leuk.
Nice. Nee, ja.
Ze hebben inderdaad waarschijnlijk niet genoeg potlood.
Ja, of dat ik... Of moet de stemmers in de gaten houden dat ze de dingen erin gooien en zo. Dat kan ook.
Mm.
Nou ja, ik zie wel. Nou...
Maar je hoeft niet te tellen.
Nee, nou dat moet officieel ook nog. Maar het ligt eraan hoeveel mensen ze nodig hebben, zeg maar.
Ik dacht dat je voor het tellen betaald kreeg ook.
Ja, klopt. Ja, de een is vrijwillig en de ander is betaald. Dus,
okay. En jij krijgt het niet betaald?
Waarschijnlijk niet. Ligt er ook wel aan hoeveel uur.
Okay.
Ik moet even nadenken, want ik moet er wel om 7 uur 's ochtends al zijn. Dus misschien...
Dat als, als je daar zo lang doorgaat dat je deze les mist, dan beter krijg je betaald.
Ja, daarom, ja. Dus ik denk het wel, omdat je dan zoveel uur bent, zeg maar, dat ze dan wel betalen. Dus nou ja, ik wens jou succes en tot over 2 weken.
Ja, tot over 2 weken.
Doei, doei.
Doei.